Hey, what's up, YouTubers? Casual706 here, back with another Transformers unboxing slash review. Today, I am really excited. I've been hunting for this guy crazy. It's been a while since we got a Hot Rod toy. Today, I'm covering Firedrive and Autobot Hot Rod Deluxe Class. As we see from the packaging, we have Firedrive popping off of Hot Rod right here in the artwork in the background. We got Hot Rod in his car mode, which is very reminiscent of the G1 toy. We got Firedrive there with his bland gray paint job. Says it's going to be for ages 8 plus in 3 different languages. Transformers up the right side of the package, and the Generations logo in the top right hand corner. Back of the packaging, we have Hot Rod again, his robot form, and Firedrive. Says it's going to take about 12 steps to transform Hot Rod from his robot to car mode and vice versa. It's going to take 1 step to change Firedrive from his head form for Hot Rod to his robot form. Over on the right side of the packaging, we got Six Shot, which I'm super excited to get. I'm ready for him to pop up any day now. We got Optimus Prime right here. And we have Autobot Breakaway, also still on the hunt for him. And they show the Titan Master, Tyros. And they show the different classes of Titans Return figures, showing that the heads are interswappable on Deluxe Class, Voyager Class, and Leader Class figures. There's a little bio in the top left-hand corner. The bio reads, "With the Decepticons rising, the Autobots power up with Titan Master partners to stop them. Firedrive gives Hot Rod an electrostatic fire blast that disables the systems of enemy targets it hits." So he gives them some kind of little shock blast thingamadoodle. Alright, so with packaging out of the way, I'm going to go ahead and open this guy up. We're going to get to the review. Alright, so out of the packaging, we got this guy here. Now, they come packaged with the usual stuff. You get these little graphics card, or these little collectible cards here. Really sick artwork, by the way. I like that one. And on the back of these cards, they got little stat breakdowns like the old G1 toys had on the back of the box. So, let's see. It says his strength's going to be like 13. His speed is going to be like 12.8 or so. It's smaller than 13. His intelligence is going to be right at 12, and his firepower is going to be like 14, or like 15 probably. So he's got fairly good stats to be Hot Rod. The combined mode is given the blue lines. It adds to his power. The red lines are going to be his power by himself without the hit. Alright, so usually I just throw these off to the side in case they become valuable later. Now also with these toys we get instructions. Instructions are going to be dual-sided, showing how to transform him from the car mode to robot and vice versa. Fan them by the camera real quick for everybody. There's first side, and second side here. Show that. And that's all. Hooray for instructions! Real men don't use instructions anyway, so I'm gonna figure this out on my own. Alright, so we're gonna take a look at the figure here a little bit. We also get some blasters with this guy. A lot of these Titan Return figures have the same kind of gun things going on. Since you get two of them, you can dual wield them in his arms. Or in his hands like this. He also has a couple of tabs on his shoulders, so you could tab them in like that, and he could have shoulder cannons. And that's going to be the extent of weapon display options in robot mode. Alright, now these guns also do connect together. There's a little tab right here, and there's the other side of the tabs there. So, and on the underside, there's another little tab there and a tab there, so they just kind of put them together, and it'll snap into one larger gun out of the two. Now in this way he has the little tabs that'll hook onto his hood, and he also has the little side guns, so he could pull his arms forward and hold it like that, like a double barreled gun if he wanted to. So stick that off to the side. I'm gonna take a look at this guy's articulation real quick. Articulation with this guy, he is gonna have at the shoulders here, he's gonna have 360 degrees of rotation. At the elbow section here, he will have a swivel section, so you can get, you cannot get 360 degrees out of that. There's something stopping it. What is going on? Alright, so you don't get 360 degrees, you actually get like 359. It'll rotate all the way around and it gets stuck on the back side. I don't know if there's a problem with my toy. It looks like it should just be a swivel joint, so it should spin all the way around. But I notice the plastic kind of pushing out to the side, and I've got a little piece of orange and red plastic on my hand, so I must have a quality issue with mine on the left arm. Right arm, up at the shoulder, he'll have 360 degrees of rotation out of that. Of course, you have to be careful. He's got these wings on the back, so it makes it hard to spin that around. Over at his elbow here, again, we don't get 360. We get like 359 or so. It can't rotate all the way around. And if you notice on mine, I've got some QC issues, some worn plastic around those. So I'm going to be careful with this guy. Alright, now down at the legs here, he has a pretty good range of motion. You can come all the way forward, all the way backwards with the leg. It's on a ball joint. You can get it around 360 degrees like that, playing with the angles of the leg. At this thigh here, he can rotate that 360 degrees. And of course, he's also going to have that knee joint right there. Foot is also going to have a little pivot to help out with standing this guy up. Over at the other leg, same scenario. You'll be able to spin it around 360 degrees playing with the angle of the leg. That thigh there is going to have 360 degrees of rotation. Now I've just got little bits of plastic jumping off everywhere, turning parts and all, little shavings coming off of this guy. So I don't know if this is a common thing with the hot rod toy for everybody, but I've got all kind of little shavings falling off on the disc. Alright, over at the leg, he'll also have that knee joint, and then that foot will pivot a little bit again to help out with posability. Alright, so we looked at the articulation. Now we're going to pop off Firedrive here, take a look at the head sculpt. Bring that in for everybody to look at. Really nice head sculpt for Hot Rod. I can't complain at all. It's very reminiscent. The only problem is these little arms right here. He didn't have any flares on the G1 Hot Rod. I guess you could pop the arms off if you wanted to have a better looking head when he's in robot mode. But that's my only complaint there, is the little hands popping off or coming out the top of the helmet. Alright, so opening this guy up, that's going to be Firebolt's robot mode. Very bland gray, nothing at all, no paint on him at all. I really think it would have made a better figure if Hasbro slapped a couple of little lines of paint on this guy, maybe painted the damn eyes or something. That's really bland and plain. He's a typical Titan Master figure. He's got the screw belly button, articulation with the guy, arms will be able to come up over the head like that. His head will rotate 360 degrees like that. Then the legs will hit a sitting pose. That's about all you're going to get. They're actually the legs are made together. They're not separate. So all you can really achieve is sitting or standing poses out of this guy. So that's what you get there with Firedrive. So we're going to pop him back on Hot Rod here. Awesome looking toy. I like it and all, and I was excited to get it. I got all kind of problems with mine. The head doesn't want to pop back in or anything. So y'all be careful when you get these toys, man. Some of these apparently have some kind of issues. Anyway, all right, we got him back in the robot mode. Now, talking about the figure, let me zoom in here. All right, so zooming in, talking about the figure. The couple of things I'd complain about with this guy, for one, his lower legs are really short feeling. it doesn't feel like an accurate, I don't know, his limbs just don't feel accurate. His arms are like super long here. Hot Rod did kind of have a little bit of flare going on over his shoulder, but not nearly that big. His arms just seem real, real, real long. I'm not really fond of that. But they keep the same color scheme and everything. He is very reminiscent of the G1 version. Let me break them out real quick to actually compare by here so you guys can see that. So we got the G1 Hot Rod right here. And we got the, this would be the Classics Hot Rod here. And put one on either side and we'll make some comparisons and all and see how Hasbro has done. Now, G1 wise, we see he keeps the fire. He's got the engine on his hood with the new one. This one didn't have the engine on the hood. They actually lose all the effects of the little triangles on the legs, the stickers and all. They don't have that going on with this one. He's got the gray knee pads. He didn't really have knee pads in the G1. Basically, the only thing the color scheme stays the same. He's orange, yellow, and red. Dope color scheme. He still kind of matches up. He's got the wings on the back. Head's still very similar. The original Hot Rod was a little more boxed out. And comparing him with this one, this would be the one that he looks the most like. These are very similar. He's got the gray patches on his knees and got the engine on the hood again, Autobot symbol. These two guys look a lot more like each other. But anyway, that's gonna end. I'm gonna put these off to the side. I'm not gonna do any more comparing. He's close enough to the G1 Hot Rod for me that I was super excited to get him. So, alright, with all that out the way, we're gonna go ahead and do this guy's transformation. Alright, now first of all, this weapon that we had, you can, since the weapons are connected, you can seat the guy in the weapon if you choose to. I figured I'd just go ahead and mention that real quick. So that's what you'll get there with the Titan Master seated in the weapon. So I'm tucked that off to the side. We'll have to pull him off anyway for the transformation, so I'm just going to leave him set down off to the side for the second. All right, to start the transformation, first thing we'll do is on the back here, we're going to click this little wing panel out away from it, and then it's on a swivel joint. We're just going to swivel that around here, and this little boxy section here is just going to kind of dually push down there. That's going to become the hood and top section of Hot Rod in his vehicle mode. All right, down here at the legs, we're going to fold these wheels over to the side. They're right on the side of them. You just fold those out to the side. There's a little tab right there. It'll kind of tab in. The feet, we're going to fold those up into the back like that there. And, it looks like we're probably not going to put this wing in the way. We're going to get this out of the way for the time being. We're going to put it back up the way it was. With the feet like this, we're going to fold those over up to the back. I'm going to fold that one over up to the back. And right in the center here, there's a little tab. We're going to tab those together. And then we're going to spin the waist around here, I believe. Yep. Mine's kind of tough. All right, so we spin the waist around and probably have to reconnect those legs there since they're like that. So that's where you get with that. Now the hands are going to fold into the forearms here, just like that. And then the shoulder, you're going to kind of push up on the shoulder to bring the arms in with the legs like that. Straighten it out real good there. There we go. So it's one side. And then on the other side, we're going to do the same thing. Just going to take that little hand there, fold it into the forearm like that, and then we're going to push the shoulder up and tab the arm into the side where that leg and arm meet. So right there. Now at the top of the vehicle, we'll take this wing, spin it around, and push it right down to connect with the legs there. And last but not least, this hood is going to come up. Actually, I should have did it sooner, but you should be able to wiggle and move your stuff out of the way there. The hood is going to come up, and then this part of the hood is going to fold up like that, and you tab it all together. There we go. So there, you get Hot Rod in his vehicle mode. Make sure he's all tight together there. All right, all tabs are pushed and he's into place. Now he's got four wheels. He does roll pretty good. My surface isn't totally flat here, but he does roll real good. I love the paint scheme, love the way this guy looks. I love the red, the yellow and orange and the cockpit with the bright blue glass, or with the dark blue glass there. The cockpit will actually open up too, and you can take Firedrive here and you can put him inside a Hot Rod to pilot it. Now the hood actually has a little hood gets some trouble closing because of that guy in there. Let me see if I can, there we go. You just have to have his legs all the way forward and you can get that hood closed up. So Firedrive can actually pilot him. I think this toy would have been better if they had a little Daniel headmaster figure that popped into it. I always kind of think of that fishing scene where Hot Rod was with Daniel, so I kind of see them as like buddies together. So I think it would have been cooler if they had Daniel as the Titan Master for him. But for the way the figure turned out, we'll take whatever you gave us, Hasbro. Now, as I mentioned with this weapon here, when combined, you do get these two little tabs on it, and right on the engine grill there, you can tab that gun into that, so he can ride with the dual cannons on the front there if you wanted to. It's kind of silly though, in that way. I don't really like that, how that looks. Now you can also take the cannons off, and you can stick them up by the feet there. Course it would scrape the ground like that, so you'd probably want to do it with the tabs facing up. You can put it on the side like that to have two cannons on the side, or you can put it on the other side here like that, or you can separate the guns and put them on both sides, so you could have you could do like that and have guns on both sides of them if you wanted to. Alright, so I'm going to stick them guns off to the side there, and I'm going to compare the vehicle modes with the different Hot Rods real quick. Alright, so all three Hot Rods lined up. We got the Classics version, the Titans Return, and the G1 Hot Rod. As you see, they all kind of look the same. Car mode, this is the wackest. With the painted blue windows, is not very cool looking. But the Titans Return figure does kind of keep the G1 thing going on. We got the engine on the hood, Autobot symbols, same paint job. He's got orange headlights there, the yellow wing on the back there. Of course, all three of them have the yellow wings and the engines and all. They're all three good Hot Rod toys, but I'm super excited. This was a really good update for the G1 Hot Rod. I mean, I'm just going to go ahead and push him out of the way. These guys look very similar. If you look at it, they did really good matching up with this. If I had any complaints in the vehicle mode, I guess the only thing would be if they painted these chrome, that would look so sick. But they opted for the gray, I guess. If they had did it chrome, that would have been awesome. All they had to do was take some of the paint they used on the engine to put on the side pipes, and that would have been cool. And it might have been nice to spruce up the rims, put a little silver on that. That would have been cool to do, or whatever. And hell, maybe even a little heat rub on the top there. If Hasbro started doing the heat rubs again, that'd be pretty cool. But anywho, that should cover my unboxing review for Transformers Titans Return, Firebolt, and Hot Rod. If you guys like this video, be sure to give it a like. Comment to the video. I don't get many comments on my videos. You guys let me know if I'm doing good or if you enjoy these things. Please leave a comment. And Also, subscribe to my channel for more updates in the near future. So, that should conclude everything. I appreciate the view again, guys. Casual 706, out.